Cameron, he clearly questions this newfound DNA that police say places him right back at the crime scene nearly 20 years ago. When I talked to him at his brother's house here in Winston-Salem, where he says the new DNA test caught him completely off guard.
One day after police announced Joseph Abbitt may not be as innocent as first appeared.
Mr. Abbitt is the prime suspect in this attack and assault.
Abbitt speaks out about the latest development where police say they found his DNA on the bed sheets of the two sisters he was convicted of raping back in 1991. Abbitt tells WXII 12 News, "I said it from the beginning. I did not rape those two girls. And I'm still saying it. I didn't do it." The motion signed last September cleared Abbitt of the charges. It's a motion the North Carolina Center on Actual Innocence stands by, and the reason the center fought so hard to clear his name and get him out of prison.
I'm not aware of anything that he could be charged with.
Defense attorney David Freeman, who has no ties to this case, says double jeopardy clearly applies.
The Constitution, according to the Fifth Amendment, says you shall not be tried for the same crime twice. If you have been acquitted of the crime, that's it.
This motion not only acquitted Abbitt, but found him innocent.
That has more weight than anything, because in most trials, again, you don't ask a jury to find, I don't ask a jury to find somebody innocent. I found them not guilty, which means the state hasn't proved that they are guilty. This has gone a step further, saying not only are they not guilty, but they're innocent.
Now, tonight, we are still waiting to see what the Forsyth County DA, Jim O'Neill, has to say about this case, the evidence that police handed over to him. He's at a conference out of town, and it's unclear when he's heading back to town. Now, at 6 o'clock, we had a chance to talk to Daryl Hunt. You're going to hear what he has to say about this newfound DNA and also what the North Carolina Center of Actual Innocence is saying about why Abbitt's DNA, it was potentially in those bed sheets. We'll have that angle of the story new at 6. For now, reporting live outside the Forsyth County Hall of Justice, Jermont Terry, WXII 12 News. Cameron?